All right, the classical crossover supergroup Il Divo is taking on Broadway. The multinational quartet begins its first ever series of shows Thursday, November 7th, today, at the Marquee Theater in Times Square.
And Il Divo gave us a sneak peek at what audiences can expect to see, and John geeked out like a teenage girl at a Bieber concert.
That's true.
Urs, Sebastian, Carlos, and David, Il Divo, welcome to the couch. This is so cool.
He's just excited. He said your name's right.
Urs. Absolutely.
Hold on. Tell us about you guys coming to Broadway. We're very excited. What's going on?
Well, for us, it's a very exciting experience, you know, being in New York for such a long time. We've never been to one place, you know, and occupying the space, being in David City. He lives here, so that's very exciting to get the atmosphere, presenting a new show with a new repertoire. It's all Broadway stuff, basically the best song that you've heard on Broadway.
Il Divo was created by Simon Cowell. He had the brilliant idea to bring all of you together. Was there any doubt that you would all get along and hit it off?
Well, actually, I think the first couple of years there was a whole lot of... there was a whole lot of trying to figure out how to communicate with each other, not just verbally, but also musically, trying to figure out how our voices would blend together, how our personalities would blend together. But, you know, here we are 10 years later, and we're kind of like a family now. We're like brothers. Or sisters.
Well, and the Lennon
sisters.
Wait a minute.
That would be Divas.
It's the Lennon sisters.
With fears.
So now, but language, you sing in all these beautiful languages. I would imagine all the languages that are represented here help in that endeavor as well, right, Carlos?
It does. I mean, obviously, we speak about near five languages between us all together. And yeah, helps a lot. I mean, obviously in the opera you sing a lot of languages, and sometimes it depends which musical theater you do. I mean, for myself, I did it in Spain, so it was in Spanish. So yeah, we sing a mix of everything.
Your new album is a musical affair, and you sing a collection of Broadway songs. There's so much great music to choose from. How did you decide?
Well, we started off with a big, big list of songs, and then we just... As Sebastian said earlier, we just wanted to make kind of a cross-section through the whole repertoire. So we have got stuff that goes all the way back to the 40s, but then stuff as modern as well as The Lion King or We Will Rock You, a song from Queen, which plays on the West End in London. So, yeah, we've got a broad variety, but we've just done one album now, and the repertoire is so huge, I think we could do two, three, four more.
Tell us about some of the duets. Singing with Barbara Streisand, what was that like?
Working with her was... absolute pure joy. She's a wonderful voice, a consummate artist, consummate professional, and just she made us feel very welcome to be part of her tour, and it was just a great experience.
You want to break any news here today? Any duets that might be featured in the Broadway show with some Broadway stars?
Any special guests showing up on stage?
Well, we're gonna have Heather Headley for sure.
Okay.
Maybe others, but we cannot say it.
Come on.
This is to come in and check it out.
You know who you should get? Jody Applegate. This woman sings all the time. She could do.
Well, I don't like to brag, but I was in the Hershey Park Hoedown once.
There you go.
It's awful polite of you to laugh.
It is such an honor to meet you guys. I just am curious. How often do you get together? You have separate lives. How often are you together on the road in any given year?
I think we almost should put it the other way. You know, how often are you separated from each other? In fact, we are together constantly. We've had a bit of a break right now, but we are either promoting our album, which is always exciting to present something that we're very proud of, or touring. And we didn't feel like the need of a rest, you know, resting, because, you know, as the momentum is still here and we're excited about things. So what we want to do is keep going, really, until we get exhausted from it, and then we'll have to take a rest.
And right now it is time for that classic Tonight from West Side Story. Here is Il Divo.
Tonight, tonight, there will be no...
make this sense.